It's not often that a car comes along that is a true game changer, but 10 years ago, that's exactly what Mercedes-Benz provided. Strangely for Mercedes-Benz, it wasn't because of some safety feature that had never been seen or some unheard-of system in the car, but because they took a design idea that sounded incongruous, but they executed it perfectly. The idea was to merge a sleek coupe shape with a practical four-door layout, and the car was the CLS. It spawned an arms race all on its own, with Audi creating the A7 and then BMW building the 6 Series Gran Coupe. Merck and BM have gone on to create miniaturized versions in the CLA and 4 Series Gran Coupe, and no doubt Audi isn't far behind. Now in its second generation, the CLS has recently undergone some midlife changes. Thankfully, they have very little to do with the styling of this car. The first generation CLS came in for a bit of flack for looking a bit like a Ford Falcon, but the second generation put pay to all of that nonsense. This car has an almost impossible mix of aggression and beauty and finesse and muscle, and the updates have done nothing to change its position as a modern classic. The changes themselves include a new grille, new headlights, and new taillights, but before we get to the big news, take a moment to appreciate the awesomeness of the CLS. Now that that's over with, let's concentrate on the more practical elements of the update. There are a bunch of new engines, including a V6 turbo petrol in the 400 and a pair of diesels, a 190 kilowatt V6 in the 350 and this 150 kilowatt 500 newton meter four cylinder in the, well, I hesitate to say entry level, but entry level 250. The 250 CDI is matched to a 7G-tronic 7-speed auto gearbox with drive to the rear wheels. You may turn your nose up at a 700,000 rand car with a 4-cylinder motor, but the fact is manufacturers have to do all they can to meet ever-tightening emissions regulations, so small engines in big cars are here to stay. Having said that, I wasn't crazy about the idea of this engine. Not because I thought it would be underpowered, but because the last Mercedes-Benz diesel I drove was also a four-cylinder, and that wasn't the most refined thing in the world. And that kind of clatter in this kind of car would absolutely ruin it. As it turns out though, it's not ruined. There is some noise on startup, but once you're cruising, it's fairly respectable. And its 500 newton meters are dished out in a very smooth and civilized way, which means shifting this big thing is quite effortless. That's a bit of a theme with the CLS. No matter how you drive it, even this most modest of models does a great job of delivering. It'll calmly cruise along until you reach a set of decent corners and want to have some fun. At which point, it'll respond with decent agility and deliver not a little bit of satisfaction. This is a Mercedes-Benz, so the update wouldn't be complete without some technical innovations, and there are a few, including a 9-speed gearbox as standard on some models, and a new LED lighting system that technically is the first of its kind on the market, but technically kinda does the same job as the one that's been around for a while in the Audi A8. Comprised of individually controlled LED clusters, the headlight system effectively gives you the best possible forward lighting. It can shut off separate elements in the headlight to avoid blinding oncoming traffic, which means you can leave the high beam on permanently. It'll also preemptively switch on cornering lights when you approach corners and traffic circles, and it knows where those are because it's hooked up to an onboard camera system that reads the road ahead. As clever as all that is though, that's not what makes this car special. There is definitely an X factor to this car. The ride setup isn't perfect, the steering has an odd artificial feel at low speed, and the cabin is a little bit noisier than you might expect thanks to those 19-inch AMG wheels. But probably because of the way it looks, and an interior that does everything with a touch of luxury, it just makes you want to drive this car. and when you do drive it, the interior plays its part in adding to the experience. Admittedly, our test car is fitted with a few options, including the 60,000 Rand exclusive package that adds a microfiber roof lining and other luxury touches. But even the basic spec of the CLS oozes comfort and refinement. Rear passengers, both of them, have decent space, despite the fact that the coupe shape naturally deletes headroom. But that same shape also means a decent-sized boot. I'm happy to admit that I am a fan of the Mercedes-Benz CLS, and not just because of the way it looks, but because of its other talents too. It's a great cruiser, but it doesn't mind driving with a bit of enthusiasm, and the interior, even in its most basic form, still manages to be somewhat luxurious. But the best thing about it is that it manages to be such a great package without really trying too hard. It may only have four cylinders, but with 500 Newton meters, the CLS 250 CDI never struggles, and once it's up to speed, it has a civilized diesel soundtrack. With classic looks and great all-round ability, the CLS remains top of the four-door coupe pile. The steering can feel over-assisted at low speed, and the optional 19-inch wheels are noisy though.